Okay, welcome everyone. So today, on the Thursday, we have community scrum, and today we will focusing on the discussion management. So today we have some topic that we will discuss. Actually, the first, I think there are still some dependencies from the previous discussion, and then there are also the four new topic for today. Okay, let me check for the previous dependencies ya. Okay, so from the partner stage and partner transformations discussion, I saw there is still one actionable from the, I think, Lilis. Please give the detailed explanation to ASA paper. Is it already done, ASA or Lilis? About the partner stage?
I think the further explanation isn't done yet.
So when do you want to, when do you have plan to have this? Minggu, okay. So on 20, yeah? On 20, okay. So will be Lilis, sudah, and ASA. Okay, and then please put the conclusion here ya, after the discussion. And then here, Nadine, please define more about the partner requirement. I will attach the summary of the discussion here soon. The discussion will be on the today at 4 p.m. When is today? Is it today or on Zoom? Okay. Mrs. Secretary, call you please tag Nadine about the specific date that she will attach the summary, because today it's very ambiguous like that. Okay, and then the next, this is the discussion about the partnership with the tourism school. So this is here the milestone that Felicia will do it. And then Felicia also already create the card for this all the action. I think all this action already what's called migrate to the Felicia card. So I will take this because it's already on the Felicia initiative card on the our Trello board. Okay, so the next is about the beef. Inside, yeah, I think this is already done as well. Okay, today we will discuss about the BVC top. This is from ASA. So, yeah, the first question is the hypothesis about the. About the why the property partner have ever joined the BVC talk. Okay, so from the ASA's perspective, because of the language, because most of our meeting is using English, but most of our property partner is using Bahasa Indonesia. So that's why maybe they decide to join, or they not confident to join the CTalk. And then from this, from the Felicia touch is the CTalk title is not click baiting enough. Maybe we could try adding this relevant keyword, how to do something specific. I noticed that the title are just name of the speaker, but correct. Okay, compelling poster or thumbnails, occasional door prize, even just 50k or get. Will usually do. Okay, so Felicia suggest to change our title on the YouTube because I think the title as well it's very general and then not like a specific. I think currently we use like a Bukit Vista, the name of speaker, and then also the company name, right? But I think we need to improving that, like something that make people interesting to open our video like that. So we can also see from the other YouTuber, maybe like Atta Halilintar or something. So yeah, I think on the conclusion, we can improving on our title, also our thumbnails, our poster on the like a thumbnails kan, you know thumbnails right? When yeah, I think need more attractive like that, like other YouTuber like that. So very attractive and then connect with the title as well. So I think mostly the people that upload this video is me on the YouTube, and then for people that making the title and then thumbnails, I think thumbnails it's suddenly me as well, because I just use the what's called the thumbnail that already prepared by YouTube like that. So I just choosing which one. Yeah, I think this is I need help maybe from Asa for the what's called the new proper title for the next. Yeah, or maybe we can also when we got the template, the good title, I think we can also change for the all the our video like that. So all our video title to improve the title. Okay, and then also for the thumbnails, I think we can make it on Canva for or something like editing. Yeah, I think I need a person who can make the thumbnails well here.
Usually Rose that.
Rose, can you make the thumbnails for our BVC Talk video?
BVC Talk introduction video, yeah.
Yeah.
No, the introduction video, Rose. This is for our specific the day of the C Talk, and then we need to create a design for its thumbnails. Just its thumbnails, the picture for its thumbnails, not the introduction video of BVC Talk. It is different kind of video, right? You know, when we conduct a C Talk, we have
okay. Let me find the example.
Yeah. And that's the different kind of video that we were talking about in the introduction video.
Okay, for example like this, Ross. For example like this, the thumbnails like the picture in the front. So make it like interesting like that. Can you make it for the BVC Talk?
Can you give the example?
I think most of our video there is no thumbnails, ya. Menurut aku, kayak we don't have the good thumbnails like that.
Yeah.
That one Mahalati interior design tadi di atas kayaknya.
Mahalati ya.
Yep, contohnya.
Ah, this one.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah, I think this is just the picture of from the meeting, right? Asa.
Yep.
I think we need to create something interesting, Ros.
About like persuade to partnership group TikTok gitu ya kontennya.
Enggak, lebih kayak ke picture like a picture, but like you can arrange like maybe from the with the Bukit Visa team picture, and then also the community expert, and then some work that making the people interesting to watch the video like that.
Okay, yeah. I think I can do it presentation format. And also evidence our work evidence on C Talk like that.
Yeah.
Nadia, I can help making the thumbnails.
Oh, I.
Oh yeah.
Also, you can help to make the thumbnails.
Yeah, yeah, it's okay. I can.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so. Okay? Okay, so Nadia can help. Maybe Nadia, you can, if you have a bandwidth, maybe you you can help. But when you don't have that that much bandwidth later, maybe you can make the example like one example, so we can have a clear picture what is the kind of thumbnails that good for the audience like that. Okay, so
oh yeah, sure, maybe I can have I can create like a template on Canva, right?
Yeah,
and then perhaps for the following like BVC talk, we can just use the same, just changing the content.
Yep
okay, okay. So we delegate to Nadia ya for the post thumbnails. Okay, thank
also,
you Nadia.
Yes, we need to collaborate with content or stuff. I think we have specific format for the title, like can we actually do the changing of the title format or not?
Okay, so the topics, yeah. Okay, then so let's discuss with the I think Rizal on here. Just take Rizal about the title, the what's called the format of the title. So who will be include the meeting? Is it Asa?
I will ask Kak Rizal for this.
Okay, so Asa will have a meeting with Rizal to talk about the format of the thumbnails, yeah. Okay, thank you. And then the next, this is the suggestion from Felicia, is about the dot price or like GoPay or OVO for the audience. I think this is the audience that joined the meeting, right? Maybe for the suggestion from the Felicia.
I guess so.
Yeah. What do you think, Lilis? Do we have the budget for this? Not worth it. Okay. Okay, Asa, did you agree what Lilis' opinion?
Yeah, I agree with that.
Okay, so what is the reason?
I think because of our partners have ever joined the BVC Talk, and that I think that's not really that interesting to be put into the press stuff. Like, you know, when we give the press, that doesn't mean that other partners will join. That cannot menjamin gitu kalau orang lain juga bakal datang ke BVC Talk-nya.
Okay, then so I think this is also related with the Rose project, right? About the partner persona. I think we need to analyze the motivation of our partner. Yeah, for example, like maybe like they have attend some like a meeting in for example, like when we are talking with the partner. Maybe they what we can ask like what kind of meeting or event that you very interesting to join like that. So maybe they will tell us, right? For example, like there is a prize, there is I meet the new people or I meet a fair artist or something. That's the motivation why the partner want to attend the meeting or the event, right? Then we can analyze, for example, like we can take maybe the example like a 20 or 10 partner to get the persona like that. What is the most motivation of our partner to join event or meeting like that? Yeah, I think Ross, because you working on the partner persona, maybe you can including that data, yeah, the motivation to attend the event or meeting. Okay. Ross, do you... okay? Yeah, so I think that also can be the actionable on the conclusion. Okay, do you have any idea about that?
Katandi, do you think that this will including what our partners actually want and what our partners actually need for the committee experts? Because I think we just do outreach like randomly and not focused to one or two objectives to find our partners' needs and wants. So yeah, I think the supply and demand doesn't match. That's why you also want another hypothesis for this CTalk.
Okay, so this is actually the main purpose of the CTalk itself, right? So the main reason why we create this CTalk. Okay, so here why I think previously why we making this CTalk, because we want to build a connection with the expert. We prepare all the expert that we think will help the partner. That's why it's not connect with the what the partner need and then what we make right then, because the first idea why we create the CTalk is we just prepare everything, like the architect, the contractor, everything, and then we think our partner need that expert, and then when they need that expert, they can visit our community page whenever they need like that. So it's not like a personal needs and then we find the expert. Personal this partner need this and then we find the expert like that. Previously the
idea, like investment, right?
Yeah, so the previous idea like that, and then it's transformed, become the second version, I can say, like a second version. We make the funnel, the end funnel is the partner usage. Nah, so partner usage, we only contacting the expert if there is any request from the partner. Nah, that's the second version, right? So the end funnel is we need to make sure our partner using the service of our community expert. And for example, that's why we collaborate with the pest control, because the partner is requesting the pest control and then the pool maintenance or everything like that. And then now I think I can say this is will be the third version of the BVC Talk. Yeah, so we need to make it clear what's called main reason of this BVC Talk. Like that, if Asa think that we need to connecting the supply and demand, yeah, that I think that will become the same like the second version by the partner request, right? And then the friction before is that's a blocking step or flow like that, because if there is no request from the partner, then we are not growth our community expert community.
Yeah, that's the friction actually.
Yeah, like that. So here we have the two option actually. We want to build what's called connection or network with the community expert, and or we just focusing on our partner that will use the what's called the service from the community expert like that. Okay, so on my side, I think the third version can be like this. This is my suggestion, Asaya. So we can grow our community expert, and then actually we can get the opportunity from the community expert to get new partner like that, because we are currently working with the community expert that related in the tourism industry, right? And then most of them is connecting with the partner or the owner, property owner. Yeah, and then we can get the opportunity actually, like we actively engage with them. We actively engage with them, like, hey, when is your last project, like that, and then where, and then maybe, oh, like the contractor, oh, I had to make a villa in Jimbaran, it's very beautiful, villa and everything. Oh, do you know the partner? Like that, so we can ask that, and then we can think like, what is the benefit for the expert that telling us that, and then what is the benefit for the partner that join us like that. Yeah, so the actionable now is like, we need the partner manager for the community expert who will focus to connect or engage with the community expert, because currently I think there is no one is actively connect with them. Now, because currently we only have the partner manager for the each region, like mm-hmm. region 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then for the partner manager, I think we don't have the person that actively engage with them. That is, so the conclusion is, who will be the partner manager for the community expert?
Okay, I think because this is actually will be connected to Jing Circle, and this also will be delegated to PR.
Yeah.
So currently it's still me at the moment, but just like interim, and then the next delegation will be given to PR team. But I don't know when, because currently Jing is still looking for the person.
Okay, so I think we cannot like apa ya bahasa Inggris, menggantung, like hanging. We can yeah. hanging like in something that not clear, right? Mm-hmm. So I would like to delegate you for the temporary to handle the community expert. What do you think? Or do you have any candidate that you want to delegate, Asa?
Currently, I don't really have one. Just Iron for the help from PR.
Who?
Iron.
Iron from the PR.
Yep.
Okay, so maybe can you meeting with Iron to talk about this? Maybe if she can do it, or if she can she cannot do it, maybe you can take it that for temporary. But of course, I will also help you from the backup for the backup like that, Asa.
Okay,
got then. Okay, so that's the conclusion. So delegation for the partner manager is Asa, and then Asa will nominate Iron, but need to meeting with Iron first, yeah. Okay, thank you. Yeah. Do you have any other question from this topic, Asa?
Second question is, actually, I'm still also thinking yeah. about how to create engagement with our committee experts, because yeah, it's kind of different when we meet partners and committee experts. Mm. Like, I think different method or something else. I don't know. I'm still confused on how to create engagement with our committee experts.
Okay, so this is our partner, but there is another different type of our property partner, right? So our property partner, yeah. we can engage with the something like with the operational booking and everything, but with the community expert, you don't know how to engage with them, what topic that you will bring, right? Okay, maybe to Ross, maybe do you have any idea for Asa? How we connect with the community expert?
I think my first suggestion is like to make a CE community expert sharing session with partner who want to have, like, if our partners have problems about or need consultation about architect or design interior or like cleaning their property, we can like connect them, make even between CE and partners. And for good long-term engagement is
okay, yeah. So make a fun to have a discussion session with the partner and then the community expert, right? But that's if the partner requests, or we just create that session, Ross?
Yeah, if our partner have requests, yeah.
Okay, so that will be a passive engagement, right? So not yeah. like an active engagement. Yeah, because if I think... for the passive, we cannot, that's uncontrolled. We cannot control, because that's if there is no request, then we not have engagement with the partner, with the engagement, with the expert, right? So I think Asa need something that how we actively connect with the expert. Okay, maybe Jenna, do you have something from HR that you can bring on this topic? Maybe how you connect with the your maybe expert in HR, how you actively connect with the your connect your network.
I want to ask, like, what exactly is the benefit are you bringing for your partners for through this C-talk?
Okay, so the community expert is kind of like a company or an expert, something like an architect, a contractor, and then like pest control, everything. And then we have a partnership with them. So if our property partner need someone that he can trust to fixing their property or create a building on contractor, we can recommend our expert to the partner like that. So but here the problem is how we still have the connection with the expert like that, so we don't lose the contact with them.
So like the main purpose is to keep the contact with the community expert and yeah. Not about the partnership. Oh, okay. Let me think. I think like perhaps for the community expert, right? Maybe if you engage with your partners and then you see, oh, which partner is like interested in this kind of like community expert services, then you can recommend it to them. But like, it will also depends because like for the community expert, like all the architect, all this kind of like projects is very need a lot of finances. So it depends heavily on the partner as well, whether they are really going to engage in this kind of like transformation for their property.
I see. So to connect with them, I got your point. Okay, maybe Asa, do you have something that you want to save from the Jenna suggestion, opinion or opinion?
Actually, I think it's kind of similar with Rose's idea because it's passive engagement.
Okay, I see. So that's passive engagement, right? So yeah, I also put my opinion there, Asa. So for the active engagement, maybe we can create this is also related with the social media theme like that, maybe we can create like expert day like that, for example, like the community expert day, like maybe for example every Saturday or every Friday we collaborate with our expert to make an event, either that's online event or offline event like that. So we can use the live session on the Facebook. For example, like so today for example today we will collaborate with the architect.
And we lost your connection.
Okay, hello. Is it already clear? Hello? Hello, hello?
Yeah, better.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so the idea is like that. So we can create an event, for example, like a Friday event or Friday expert. So we can use the live session feature on the Facebook, for example, if online or offline, maybe if our expert is available on the venue. So we can collaborate with the expert, for example, like an architect. Okay, so we will bring this material or this something interesting for our partner in the live session like that, what Chucha restaurant did like that, for example, they have art painting class or something interesting for example to the people. And then when I go to the Chucha on the mural painting, that's a lot of people join, actually. It's in a lot of people join on that event. I not expect that much people come, but it's the booking is full. So I think that's a good idea as well to our expert to, that's also help them is to branding their company like that, right? So we can help to arrange the event to our property partner or even though the potential property partner. So to join. Yeah, if for example like we don't have much attend from the our property partner, but we can also spread that information to the other property owner in other community to join. So we can have a sharing about the architect, about the how to manage the villa, by the pest control or everything like that. So I think that's one of the my suggestion that we can use for the active engagement with the partner. Okay, back to Asa, what do you think?
I think we can do that if the community expert have an even, I mean like if they are willing to do that as well. So yeah, we can consider that actually. And also for the social media, it actually connect with Felicia's campaign then. We can create like you, as you said, like Saturday expert or stuff, and then we can promote them and as well as introduce themselves to our property partners. That can we can do that actually.
Okay.
Thank you, Katandi, for the insight.
So can you try one connect with one expert that available maybe for the next week? We will do MVP for that. We can see how is that idea is going like that.
Okay. Yeah.
If next week you don't have the bandwidth, maybe you can arrange when you available and then expect that. Okay. Thank you. So that's the action for the next action. Okay. So I think for this topic it's already covered, yeah, Asaya. Okay. So we will go to the next topic. This is from the business development. Invitation. This is the invitation from the business development to all community team to attend the BD alignment meeting in the every Wednesday. So the objective is to track onboarding progress by community management to have the alignment if there is any friction related to business development in onboarding process, to spot file on onboarding and get action quickly. Okay, so this week discussion. Okay, I think Ross or Asa is attend this meeting, ya. Yeah? This is about the Amarta apartment. And then the meeting result is the owner has brought the equipment. Oh yeah, maybe to Asa. This is the conclusion of the discussion, or this is your opinion.
Katandi, we can hear you quite well.
Okay, so is this the result of the meeting last Wednesday?
Yeah.
Okay, so could you tell us more about this?
Maybe Ross, because she joined yesterday and I was forgotten to be invited, so yeah.
Okay, Ross, could you tell us more about this, Ross?
Yeah, about the discuss, so we discuss about onboarding process. Business development asks about our onboarding process, SLA, but I already tell them about the onboarding process, apa namanya? SLA-nya udah kasih tahu. And ini kan Amarta apartemen, the owner said that they take 30% package. So business development needs to discuss about onboarding process checklist based on commission package. Jadi like it's different from 20% or 50%, jadi ada tambahan checklist gitu yang mau dibicarain sama business development, tapi nggak ada yang terpas dari Didi.
I see, so Amarta take the 30% package, ya?
Iya. Yeah.
Okay, and then Pak Imam as a vendor to manage the property, right?
Yep.
Okay, I see. Okay, then so yeah, got it. So so for the equipment, the owner is already buy the equipment, yeah, so that's okay. And then also for the Hearta, okay, Did you do the inspection? Do you will go to inspection today?
Yeah, after this scrum, I will directly go there. But the owner is currently in slow response again. So yeah,
I see.
We'll call him maybe.
Okay then. So this is just the invitation from the business development to update the owner performance on the onboarding process. So if there is any friction, community can report back to the business development, and then business development also can help to follow up with the partner. Yeah. Okay. So the conclusion is CM will attend the meeting on the Wednesday. Or perwakilan CM juga bisa, and then also I think we can report the progress or the performance of the property when we are doing the onboarding with them on the PRM. So I think that's the good place where we can document the history, the engagement like that. Okay, thank you. So, is there any question about this topic?
How about the onboarding process checklist based on commission package? Itu gimana, Kak?
Which one checklistnya? Checklistnya yang mana? Onboarding process checklist based on commission package. Onboarding process checklist based on onboarding process checklist. Based on commission package.
Maybe I will talk to Mok ya, to Mok.
Yeah, onboarding process. I think we in community we are only did the welcoming program, right? Is it same with the onboarding process or is it different with the welcoming program checklist?
Yeah, but business development like consider the 30% package to add some several checklist gitu loh, Kak.
Several checklist regarding what, Ros?
Aku coba.
Paket apa nih?
Karena ini dibahasnya itu sebenarnya hari ini, cuman nggak datang dari.
I see. That's I think you can coordinate with Wayana ya, Ros ya. The checklist regarding what? Is it there, regarding the flow of the welcoming program of the or the checklist regarding the what the partner will get if they take the commission? If they take the commission package like that. For example like the 30% they get the revenue manager or they got the what kind of the service like that, is that regarding that or regarding the welcoming program? If about the commission package, I think the discussion I think not only in CM, but we need to also gather the BI, also the I think product development, also if what kind of product that we can give if they take more commission or something. Or I think this is can be bring up to the BI weekly discussion, yeah. Because all the chapter VCL and NCL is attend there. Like that, yeah. Maybe you can make it clear with the Mok Wayan first. What is Simin about this? And then after that's clear, you can. Tell, put it on here so we will know where's this discussion will going. Is it on the CM or another chapter like that? Okay, is there any further question? Okay, all good, yeah. So I will move to the next discussion. We still have 17 minutes. I think that's 17 minutes. I think that's enough. Okay, so here my question is, what is the most friction to handle the partner in the each region for partner manager currently? Okay, so please put three friction that makes your work slowly. Like that. So here, my current friction is build connection with and trust with the partner that I never meet. And then the second is analyze performance to, of its property so I can make the actionable for that. And then the arrange cleaning class for to find good trainer. Okay, I think from my friction first, I would like to just, I think the first friction is same with Asa, yeah? Okay, so, yeah, currently my friction is because now I handle the region 1, and then previously I'm actively to only handle the region 2 and 4, but now I am handle the region 1. There is still some partner that I never meet, and then there is no communication before. Yeah, I try to communicate with them. For example, like Elliot in Villa Tortoise. Elliot, I communicate with them and everything, and then he said like this, oh yeah, I will improve when I meet the Villa, when I give them some suggestion. But he contacting Jake again, like that. He contacting Jake again, and then asking, hey, why my performance of my Villa is not good, like that. So, yeah, actually, this is about the trust, right? The trust and then connection. Because I had contact the owner, but the owner is contacting Jake, like that. For their insight, like that. I think this is... so far my problem or issue like that, or maybe to Asa, do you have that same experience, or do you have another experience of about the trusting and connection?
Actually similar to you, but maybe because most of my partners in region 3 are not familiar with me, and then they ask through the group or ask to BD or anything BV in the group, like, is this your employee, like, yeah, like that, just to make sure. But I think that's fine actually, just yeah. Just because they haven't known me before, so yeah.
I see. Okay, so is it maybe to Lilis, do you have any suggestion for how we improving for the next? Lilis, oh nggak bisa ngomong ya? Quality control. Try for that. Oh, I see. I think what Lilis mean is we try to do the property quality control, and then when we do that, we can meet with the partner, right? But the friction, actually the friction is like this, Lilis. For example, like the most of the partner in region 1 is not in Bali. They stay like in their country, like that. For example, like Elliot, they stay in Australia or America, and then in the property is only the staff, the cleaning staff. Yeah, and then mostly if there is any discussion to owner, to the partner, yeah, that's the friction actually, and then the partner didn't respond quite well to me, for example, like that. Yeah, what do you think? Yeah, if Lilis still can answer, maybe answer. If okay, intinya sampaikan dan bagi kita aja. Okay, so Lilis said that we just tell what our purpose, yeah, our purpose to the partner, to the owner. Okay, maybe to Nadia. Maybe do you have any suggestion, Nadia, from your experience to contacting the new partner?
Okay. Actually, not much for me because this happened once, so I'm not really sure what can be improved from my side. But yeah, perhaps from my experience while contacting the partners, we're like the response time. Like sometimes, some of them really active, like they reply really fast, they're very enthusiastic. It's actually really good, but a lot actually not even responding once. So yeah, that's probably my friction.
Yeah, I think also my assumption, and that's also about the trust, maybe. They actually read it, right? I got that case as well, like they read it, my message, but they not even responded my message like that. Even though I send the second message, hey, did you read my message? They just still read it and then not replying like that. So because I worry that they still have a meeting or something, that so it's not polite maybe. So yeah, that's why I confirm them on the WhatsApp first. Hey, do you have time on that like that? But yeah, I think this is about the trust. So yeah, let me think. What is the best?
Oh yeah. So how do we improve the trust then?
Why? I have an idea. I have an idea actually. So what about if the people actually that have the trust with that partner handover or introduce the partner manager like that. For example, like a Jing. Okay, Jing have a good connection with Elliot, right? With the owner. And then I think for what the best practice for Jing is, Jing can say to the owner, hey, currently you have a partner manager that will help you for everything or what you need. So please trust him, or you can trust him to handle your case or your feedback like that. So I think that will gain the trust from the partner, like a handover trust like that. What do you think, guys? Maybe yeah, to everyone have a suggestion or opinion about that.
Maybe my question for me.
Yeah.
So does it mean that we have to do that for every partners?
I think in the partner manager case, I think that's just one time, right? For example, like I handle region one, and then I try to find which person that the owner is most of the person that the owner contact for like that. For example, like the Elliot is mostly contacting Jing like that. Yeah, I think I can talk to Jing. Hey, for all the partner that you have a contact, maybe you can tell me to handle for the future like that. So I think that's my opinion, Nadia, like for the partner manager. Okay, so I think that's become the conclusion, yeah, the best practice, yeah. So we can do the handover trust by introducing the partner manager or the people that we want to handover, and then yeah, I think that's it like that. Okay, for example, like Asa, maybe for region 3, because mostly on the region 3 Andre know the owner like that. Maybe you can talk to Andre. Hey Andre, call you introduce me and then handover and then tell the partner if there is anything that the partner needs, you can handover to me like that. Ask him to company. Huh? Ya, apa? Kamu bilang apa? What do you say?
Buat nemenin sih.
Oh, yeah, I see. Okay then. Okay, good.
Okay.
Yeah. And then we still have 7 minutes. Yeah. The second is analyze the performance of its property. Yeah, I think this is I need to discuss with Lilis more. Yeah, because actually I would like to have an active checking like that. So I will know on this, for example, this month or last month, which property that in my region have a good performance and then have a low performance. Yeah, I think NCM we don't have that visibility yet, right? Maybe to Asa and Ross also as well, which partner that have a good performance, you don't know, right? Yeah, but regarding the revenue, for example, or the review, yeah, I think my proposal is NCM. We also need to know our property performance, so we can know the urgency like that. For example, like okay, so this this five property have a low performance last month. So I need to take care of them like that. Either like a discuss with the BI, what is the strategy for this property or everything, or improving the review or something like that. Yeah, I think I will discuss with Lilis more about that. Okay, maybe the third about the arranging the cleaning class. I think I need to asking more my friend, or if you guys have any connection in Bali that can help me. I think that will be great if you can suggest one, because the last person that I contact, he cannot do the training like that. So I need to find another people for do the training. Okay, yeah, I think we can. Why I asked this question, because I would like to know what is your what's called your friction on the work like that, and then we also can prioritize better our work like that. So I will read all this and then I will discuss with Lilis what is the best way, and then also discuss with you guys later on this paper. We can do the online discussion also, asynchronous in here. So currently I think the most problem is about the trust. So we have the conclusion, and then from this all friction, if maybe Asa, Ross, and Lilis, would you bring one most difficult problem that you that really affect your work like that? Maybe to Asa or Ross.
For me, maybe just like what you have actually said as the first friction.
Okay.
The trust.
Same, yeah. Right? But so we already have the next action for that. And then to Ross, what is your most friction?
Yeah, I think my friction is affected by out of my control, our control. Mm-hmm. Our control, it is like Nusa Penida situation is really low with visitors or guests, because tourists apa yang datang ke Nusa Penida itu cuman main doang, tapi gak nginap. Kebanyakan seperti itu berdasarkan based on BI analysis from Patricia. And my next plan is just to tetap engage ke mereka. Ada beberapa yang gak operasi, tapi ada beberapa yang masih beroperasi, but untuk mereka yang nggak operasi, aku bakalan engage ke mereka, like tetap jalin komunikasi, like balas-balas komentar mereka, status mereka di Facebook like that. Tapi untuk mereka yang beroperasi, aku bakalan coba untuk persuade to join our program yang masih belum, terus and to install Bivigo like that.
Oke, okay. Ross. Okay, hello. Yeah. Okay, Ross. So you said the about your most friction is Nusa Penida visitor is lower than other region, right? And then I know which work that relative on this friction.
Apakah?
Which work? Kerjaan apa yang berefek dari ini? Kerjaanmu yang mana yang that's affecting your work from this friction?
Yang friction banget itu.
Ya, yeah. You said the about the visitor, right? The visitor is lower, or the guest is lower. And then which work that affect from this friction like that make your working slower like that?
Yeah, their complaint. Complain about when we want to talk with them and to ask them to untuk join event atau program like kayak seperti itu it's hard because event apa, program apa, aplikasi apa, orang nggak ada tamu kok katanya gitu.
See, so that's affecting the what's called the apa ya namanya, kayak pengaruh mental gitu ya, kayak mentality of the partner. So when we outreach them, the yes. the type of the response is negative like that. It's not like open to for discussion, open for the our program, to join our program, or open on the replying the message like that.
Yeah, okay. But it's sekurang sih kak, yang mereka yang nggak beroperasi sama yang mengurangi fasilitas-fasilitasnya dan menurunkan harga.
Okay, so from that kind of partner, from the 100%, how much that kind of partner? Berapa yeah. persen sih yang kayak seperti itu?
I think 60%.
60%.
Yeah.
That have the mental. Okay, so that yeah, that's actually will affect your work because it's because the response of the partner is negative when we invite them to event. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so okay, I think that's our meeting is already finished. So we can we continue this discussion on the paper for online discussion? Okay, Ross, you can leading the discussion of your friction on the paper ya.
Okay.
Okay, nanti aku bantu untuk cari conclusion ya. Okay, thank you Ross. Okay then. Since we have run out of the time, and then I believe you guys also have another things to work on, so I will finish this meeting. Thank you Jana to join, and then also Nadia to join, and then Lilis, Asa, and Rost. So if you guys have any future question, you can put on this discussion paper if that's related to the something general and on CM. Or if there is any personal feedback, you can just contact me on the Slack. Okay, thank you very much, guys.